Hello, welcome back. So in this case, we are going to discuss about the lacing system. So lacing system is the system which is being used to connect the main component of the built-up column. So in this photo, you can see these are the main component. These are the vertical main component. And to connect these components, we have used these inclined members. So these inclined members are actually the lacing member. So these are called lacing system, and these individual members, they are called lacing bar. Okay, so this lacing system we use to connect the main component of the built up sections. So lacing system, all the specifications related to the lacing system, it is given in this clause 7.6 of the IS 800. So lacing system are basically the most commonly used lateral system in built-up compression members. So they are the most common system which we use to connect main component of the built-up column. And beside, commonly lacing bars are basically these flat bars. Flat bars look like this. Flat bars look like this. So generally this flat bar is used as a lacing member. But beside this flat bar, sometimes we use angle section also. And in case of heavy sections, if they are very heavy built up column, sometimes we use channel section also as a lateral system, which to connect the main component. Sometimes we use tubular section, like the hollow rectangular pipes or the circular pipes. So those are sections, those type of sections are also used. But the most common section which is being used in lacing system is this flat bar. And some, we call it ISF. ISF stands for Indian Standard Flat. I for Indian, S for standard, F for flat. So ISF, sometimes we represent this as, we call it ISF. And this is called the B, which is the width of flat or width of lacing bar. And this point, this is called the thickness of lacing bar. So lacing bar are of two types. First one is called single lacing, and the second one is called double lacing. I'm showing you one more photo of the lacing system. So in this case, you can see, lacing bar is connected in between the main component, but sometimes lacing is connected like this also, like they are connected on this in this manner also. So in this case, you can see lacing bars are overlapped to each other, but in this case they are not overlapped to each other. So in both case the design of connection is different. So we will discuss that in later slide. Now, single lacing look like this one. This you can see the single bar is running like this. So in this much gap, only one bar is there. While in this case, you can see in this much gap, there are two bars. One bar is this one and second bar is this one. So that is why this is called double lacing system, and this one is called single lacing system. We use double lacing system in case we are designing a built-up column to carry a very heavy load, and sometimes in case of light load we use a single lacing system. Now there are some failure modes in the built-up section when they are connected with the lacing system or other system. How those members can fail, we will see those failure modes of failure. So the member can fail. In this case, what happens is the whole built-up member may fail. This is one mode of failure. In the second mode of failure, only the main component of the built-up column is failing. So that is the second mode in which the built-up section is failing. In the third case, the section may distort. So this is the distortion of the section. This is also in case when there is a very heavy load, in that case, this distortion may occur. In the fourth case, the lattice member may fail. Lattice member means the secondary members which are being used to connect the main component of built up section. If they are failing, then that comes under this category. And now I will show you this in diagram. So in the first case, as I said, buckling of built up member as a whole. So you can see the whole system is buckling. In this case, these lines are, these are the main component. And these cross members, they are the secondary or lacing member. I'm calling this as lattice. Okay, so in this case, what is happening? The whole member is buckling. So this is the first kind of failure in which the whole member is failing. Whole member is buckling. So this is the one type of failure. In the second case, what is happening? The lacing member, I mean this lateral system, these secondary members, they are not failing, but one of the main member, in this case, this is a built-up column. These two are the main cord which are supporting the main load. But in this case, what is happening? One of the member is buckling like this. It may be buckling like this. Okay, so this kind of failure may occur in case of built-up section. Now, in the third case, the section may be distorting. So if there is a very heavy load, in that case, sometimes what happens is the section at this part, it may not be in position and it may distort. It may be twisting like this. It may distort from its position. It may displace from its position. So this is the third kind of failure, which is the distortion of the cross section. Now in the fourth case, failure of lattice member, which means these secondary member, if they fail, so they may fail like this. Here you can see the secondary member, they may buckle like this. Similarly, this may also buckle like this. This may buckle like this. So if such kind of failure is occurring, in that case, we say failure of lacing or lattice. Okay. So these are the possible failure that may occur in the built-up section. So to avoid those failure, IS code has laid out some specifications, some rules. So we will see what are those rules. So there are some requirements for the lacing system as per clause 7.6. I will be showing you this whole clause. So first requirement is compression members comprising of two main components, laced and tied, should, where practicable, have a radius of gyration about the axis perpendicular to the plane of lacing, not less than the radius of gyration about the axis in the plane of lacing. Well, this is a very tough language, which is a very difficult to understand. I will tell you, they are simply saying that RYY should not be less than the RZZ, which means, as I have already discussed this phenomena, that we will try to have RZZ equals to RYY. So this is the first requirement of built-up column or in this lacing system, that both RYY and RZZ, they should be close, they should be same. So in this case also, if this is Z axis, and if this is Y axis, so in this case, RYY should be, I mean, should not be less than RZZ. So that is the case that they are explaining. Also, it says, as far as practicable, lacing system shall not be varied throughout the length, which means like lacing system is running like this. So this length, it should be uniform. It should not be varied. So they should be provided in a uniform spacing. Now, in the next requirement is single lacing system on opposite side of the component shall preferably be in the same direction so that one be the shadow of the other, which means here in this case, you can see, for example, these are two channel sections, and if we are providing lacing on this side, say I'm saying this as face A. So on the opposite side here also, if we are providing a lacing system, then we say that whatever we are providing lacing here, if we are providing on this face, it should be the mirror image of face A, like this. They should look like this. They should not be in this manner. In this case, you can see this, it is not the mirror image, but it is the mirror image. So that is the form that we have to follow. That is our next requirement. Similarly, in this case also, there are some other also is shown here. One more thing that we never do that on, in this case again, on one face we are providing single lacing and on the other face we are providing double lacing. This is also should not be done. This is also not recommended by the IS code. We will not do that, as I said here. So we will continue our discussion in the next part. Thank you.